I've thought through some scenarios of having children. If my lady has triplets, we have to give one away. I'm a little bit older than my father was when they had me, so naturally that makes me wonder, do I want kids? Do I want to deal with children's quirks? There's quirks that come with having children. Do I want to have a small person fall asleep in public and have to carry it around the rest of the day, even though it knows how to walk, shit like that? Or like, how many horrible children's basketball games can I watch? I don't know how many 16-8 final scores a man can stomach. Like, it's scoreless at halftime, 0-0. I don't know how many back-to-back double dribbling traveling violations a man can have. I'm like, this is a referee's bonanza right here. These kids suck, but the referee is killing it right now. He hasn't missed one travel, huh? He's heartless. They gotta learn some way. No kids. I've thought through some scenarios of having children, just in case. Unlikely scenarios, but I want to be prepared. Here's one. If my lady has triplets, we have to give one away. I refuse to keep three of the same baby, man. I can't. That just seems so overwhelming, man. I'm open to having three children, but not three of the same baby. I want to mix it up a little bit. Come on, man. What do I want three of a kind for? This ain't Texas Hold'em. This is real life. Get one of those babies up out of here, man. You know how goofy that stroller situation would be? How dumb that car seat situation would be? Get one of those babies up out of here. Get that baby to somebody that can't have babies. Her body, her choice, so she can pick which baby we give away. Unless we have two girls and a boy, she can't just give away the boy. That's, come on, balance. She can pick which baby we give away. If I'm being honest, I'm hoping she picks the first one. I want her to pick the first baby, because I'm the type of dude, I don't like to grab the top newspaper at the newsstand. It just seemed like it got something on it, you know? And that's my main message today. That's really what I came here to say. If you have triplets, give one away. And I'm sorry that rhymes. That sounds like a Sugar Hill Gang rhyme. My name is Hannibal, and I'm here to say, if you have triplets, just give one away. Ooh, I'm sorry. No. I promise, give one of them away. You wouldn't even miss it. You forget all about that extra baby once you got so busy with the twins. Look, I'm already calling them twins. Fuck that third baby. I can't worry about other people's kids when I have a family to take care of over here. No kids. I have nephews and nieces. This is a perfect relationship because I don't live where they live. So whenever I visit them, it's a goddamn event every time, because absence makes the heart grow fonder. I come to my sister's house, they're so psyched. Uncle Hannibal's in town! You got that right, I'm in town, kids. Hell yeah, Uncle Hannibal's in the building, what's up? High fives all around. Yeah, Uncle Hannibal! And I always come through with the cool-ass fly uncle gifts, video game systems, GoPros, helicopter drones. Yeah! Thank you for the drones, Uncle Hannibal. You're welcome for that drone. Now, how about you come here and tell me a boring-ass school story? Oh, this is a horrible story. You didn't establish any characters or anything. This story sucks. But I love you. I won't say this to your face, but this story is garbage. And it's perfect. It's a perfect relationship. They get gifts. They get to see their uncle. I get to feel something outside of show business. We get what we need from each other, then we separate. It's perfect. They're like hookers for my sense of nurturing.
I've thought about it, and there's three reasons I don't have children, OK? Three main reasons I don't have children, and I'll share them with you. OK, here they go. Three reasons, right? One, there's millions. The world's overpopulated. No one's sitting around going, oh, Rick's not having kids, we're going to run out. But... Two, kids are scroungers, aren't they? I mean, from day one, it's all me, 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 isn't it? Feed me, clothe me, pay for my chemotherapy. No. No. Not my problem, son. Not my... Luck of the draw, boy. Luck of the draw. It costs the average household in the West $200,000 to bring up a child, right? And you don't see that back. They don't want to pay you back. They're not grateful. They don't go, oh, thanks for having me every day. They go, I didn't want to be born, right? Even if they get a top job, right, which they won't, okay? You'll never see that money back, right? They just put you in a home, okay? And my kid, he'd be born into ridiculous wealth, wouldn't he? So... he'd be a little cunt. A little Hampstead cunt. Running around with all the other fucking little Hampstead cunts. Being all Hampstead and cunty. I'm a little Hampstead cunt. Yes, I know. I know, yeah. These are my little cunty friends. Yeah, I know, it's obvious. Well, I can tell from your little fucking cunty hats that you're little Hampstead cunts. You little posh Hampstead. And on the one hand, he'd know he was a little fucking Hampstead cunt. I'm a little Hampstead cunt. Yes, we know, everyone knows, right? He'd know that, right? And on the other hand, he'd know that he could never live up to being as brilliant as his dad, right? I'd say, you know, I've worked my way up from nothing and I gave it to you and you're just a little useless Hampstead cunt. You'd go, yeah, and that would probably prey on his little mind a bit, wouldn't it? Like, 11, 12, he'd sort of be a naughty boy, run with the wrong crowd, try and get out from under my shadow, right? And then he'd turn to drugs, and about 13, he'd come home and he'd overdose on my Afghan rug. 20 grand, that was, right? And as he was there, right, convulsing and throwing up his fucking lungs, right, and with his little posh, high-pitched fucking death rattle, right, in little fucking dying words, he'd go, do you love me now, Daddy? No. No. No, I never did, and that's why you're never going to be born, you useless fucking junky Hampstead cunt. And three, I'd worry sick about him. You know, I would. I've only got a cat at the moment and I worry sick about her. I check the door three times when I go out so, you know, she doesn't escape. I put food and water in every room in case the door shuts. She's peckish for 20 minutes. Right? A human baby, oh my God, the responsibility of a human life. I'd watch it sleep. You know, we've said how weak and vulnerable they are. It's like, oh my God, you perfect little thing. You, oh, flesh of my flesh. Go to sleep in your expensive cot. Oh, night, night, sleep tight. Don't let the bed bugs, oh, dead. Yeah. Just... Why? Why is it dead? It's just fucking dead. Look. Fuck's sake. Fucking hell. What a fucking waste of time that was. Fuck's sake. Embarrassing. Jane? What? Come here. I'm in the shower. Come here. What? Fucking dead already. I just fucking... Fucking hell, Jane. You call that a baby? That is... If Jane was out, I'd have to text her, wouldn't I? What could you... Baby's dead. She'd come back, whoop, what the fuck? I'd go, yep. Forget the Pampers, lol.
Maybe I have a low tolerance for children, because I've lost a lot of great friends to kids. Because it really is like a disease in some ways, but it's worse than a disease because they want you to have it, too. They're like, you should have kids, too. I'm watching you do it, and I'm thinking I'm gonna not do it. They're like zombies, like, you should eat brains. I'm watching you eat brains, and it seems like it ruined your life. And the way you kill zombies, you probably know this from the movies, right? Is you shoot them in the head with a shotgun, or you chop off their heads with a machete or a samurai sword, which is also the way you kill anyone. So I'm talking about this with Jen, and she laughs, and I laugh, and we laugh as one. And then she says, but if we had a baby, I think it would be different. And I was like, ch-ch. You got bit! I tried to remain calm. I said, Chloe, I was very clear when we got married that I never wanted to have a kid, which, by the way, gets you nothing. Being very clear is apparently useless, because she said, I was clear I didn't want to have a baby at the time, but that I might change. And I said, I was clear I would never change. She said, if you don't want to have a baby, maybe I'll have one on my own and we can stay married. And I said, oh, that'll be a good look. Just you and me and this kid that's a cross between you and some grad student jacking his way through SUNY Purchase. I mean, you can't have a kid on the side. Like, we keep him in the shed. I mean, people do it. I've seen the documentaries. It's just, those aren't my role models. And then people will be like, you guys have kids. I gotta be like, she does. She says, a baby wouldn't have to change the way we live our lives. I said, did you get less smart? Because you used to be so smart, and what you're saying currently is factually incorrect. And by the way, I've never wanted to have a kid for 7 specific reasons. Number one, I've never felt like there should be more of me in the world. And don't get me wrong, I think one is funny. You know, one, ha ha, good one. You know what I mean? Like, let's get tickets. But I believe in survival of the fittest, and this is not the fittest. Like, I have the body of someone who's just about to start P90X and then doesn't.